Can you hear me okay?
Yes, you sound great.
Okay, I got this little mic. I've been playing around. I'm just like, okay, so long as it's crisp, this is great. Also, what program are you guys using for captioning?
It's just embedded through Zoom.
Oh, wow. Okay, cool. That's awesome.
It's when you have the pro account for webinars, though. You need a webinar extension.
Got it. That's awesome.
Let me know when you're ready to start, okay?
And I'll- okay. Cool. Thank you.
Would you like to start?
Yeah, I think so. Thank you, Luz. Luz or Luz? Sorry.
Luz.
Okay, cool. Thank you. All right. Hi, everybody. My name is Abena Motaboli. I'll be presenting on collective art and vision, art and vision making. Please go ahead and change your name to however you want to be identified today. Feel free to put your pronouns. The way you change that is the top three dots in your video screen. About myself, I'll do a physical description. I go by she, her. I am a brown non-binary person with dark natural brown hair and a wall of paintings behind me made of tea and coffee and dirt and the earth. Go ahead and tell me in the chat where you're joining from as we get started. I'm in Chicago. I don't know if everyone here is based in Chicago. Awesome, Chicago, great. Good to see some faces. Chicago, okay. So we're all waiting for summer, great. So we're here. Awesome, I wanted to start with this painting. It's a painting I recently made titled Splash. She's made up of different types of coffee, Turkish coffee, black teas, dried up flowers, which have been used in my process of fabric dyeing. I dye scarves, a ton of things. I love using flowers. Oh, awesome. Raleigh, North Carolina. Great. Thank you guys for joining. So I wanted to start with this piece because I put it out into the world recently. And whenever I create art, I feel such a sense of calm. I feel safety within myself. I feel as though I'm in a world where absolutely anything is possible. I feel like I can make beauty out of trash, which reminds me quite frankly of our world right now. But we're gonna be doing a little bit of art making with non-traditional medium. I'll touch a bit on how to make your own coffee and tea inks, simple processes. And then we'll do some paint, pigments, and that sort of thing. Before we do that, I'll do a quick intro about myself. I grew up in Lesotho, which is a tiny country in the middle of South Africa. My mom's from Ghana. I moved to the US back in 2012 to finish college at Columbia College Chicago. I have my bachelor's in fine arts. And I've been working in Chicago ever since with the Chicago Park District, with Marin Arts, with the Garfield Park Conservatory Alliance, and a bunch of different arts organizations. I am an interdisciplinary artist, painter, writer, performer, installation artist. I wear 1,000 hats, I'm sure all of you do. But I'm really inspired of land as connection, nature's home. The place that I grew up in is around 11,000 feet above sea level. There are so many mountains, it is gorgeous. And so everything that I do comes back to the earth. It comes back to the soil, comes back to where we come from. The ground is beneath our feet, whether we're on our homelands or on indigenous lands or other people's lands. I wanted to share this quote by Robin Wall Kimmerer, who I absolutely adore. She's Potawatomi, she's indigenous, she is a botanist, she's so many things, she's amazing. But she says that the land knows you even when you're lost, which I find very, very, very true. And then I wanted to share these two pieces of artwork that I've done. The one on the left was done at a residency called Respite in the Round, which is in North Carolina. That is a residency that is offered on a solidarity scale for POC folk, which is amazing. I was there for 2 weeks. I'll drop a link in the chat. And while there, I got the chance to be at Handewa Farms, which is Okanichi Saponi based land, and they have a hemp farm. They're really rooted in social justice work, environmental justice work. So that was really cool. And so this work is made of berries that I found on site, clay, the earth. I had these tarps down at a creek for 2 weeks, and I would visit these tarps day after day, just adding and doing short performances. If you're just joining, go ahead and tell us where you're joining from. Feel free to add your pronouns, your name to your chat space. Awesome. Okay. So to get grounded in the space, I want you to find 5 things that you can see. Thank you for listing your pronouns and your names. Welcome, welcome. So I just want to do a little bit of getting grounded in our space. And I want you to notice 5 things around you that you can see. You can either write this down, you can guard it for yourself, or just really notice. The next thing I want you to do is realize 4 things that you can touch that are around you. Following that, 3 things you can hear. So what are 3 things in your environment right now that you hear? Two things you can smell. I smell the smell of my teas, which we will be using later. And then 1 thing you can taste, or what was the last thing that you had? Awesome. So I want to invite everyone to quickly turn their cameras on if this is accessible, and just sort of look at the people who are around you. Notice who is around you. We are in community together. We are building together through these strange blocks. But I just want us all to realize how connected we are, and it's good to see such beautiful, lovely faces. Thank you guys for joining and just being here. Wonderful. So feel free to turn your cameras back off if you feel more comfortable that way. And I'm going to be leading us through a guided visualization. I put the agenda in the chat. After that, we will move on to art making and sharing out and closing out. If at any point you have any questions, feel free to unmute yourself or type it up in the chat. Hello to everyone's faces. Can you guys hear the sound? Oh, awesome. Okay, great. Thank you. So I want you to get into a comfortable position. Feel free to turn your video off. Feel free to sit down. Feel free to lie down, whatever you need right now. If you need to grab a glass of water, go grab that water and nourish yourself. Take care of yourself. If some of these movements are not accessible to you at the beginning stage, feel free to make adjustments as necessary. I will be playing the sounds of the root healing chakra, and I invite you to go on a journey with me together. Let's get cozy. So to start off, let's take a few collective breaths together. Take a breath in through your nose. And let it out through your mouth. Welcome a deeper breath in through your nose. And out through your nose. Breathe in. Breathing in and out. Continue this breath on your own time. And as you breathe, maybe take some neck rolls, easing off the day. You've been in back-to-back sessions or have had a day or arriving with calm, however you're arriving here. Have some movement if that feels right. Set any intentions that feel aligned for yourself. How do you want to show up to this space for the next hour? Let's honor that. Gently shake off anything that is not serving you right now. And as you continue breathing, start to become aware of your breath, of your body, of your chest gently rising as you breathe in. Notice where your body is at today. Feel it. Are you feeling light, heavy, grounded, excited, calm? Whatever you're feeling, I want you to channel that energy and be with it. Sit with it, welcome it. Take a deep breath in. Release out through your mouth. And as we breathe, I want you to ground your feet on the floor beneath you. You are grounded on the soils of this earth. And as you ground down, imagine your body as deep set roots, rooted in reimagining a world where our communities are safe, at peace, at one with each other and our Mother Earth. I invite you to think about who you are in community with and who you choose to build with. And if your safe spaces feel safe to anyone that enters, space is safe for others, perhaps you choose to invite other life forms and creatures into your space. If you choose to do so, make space to acknowledge your very human key and kin. Notice if there are any marine mammals or other creatures at ease around you. Perhaps there's a mourning dove perched somewhere in your world. Or maybe you choose to take this moment simply to explore. Acknowledge what you need to foster inner peace, deep happiness, and hope. In your world, look around yourself. Take in the lightness and breathe. Perhaps you are journeying to an imaginative garden. And if your chosen space is not a garden, imagine what your chosen place is. And as you imagine yourself in that space, start to walk around. Notice how your body feels as you walk in the space that gives you both comfort and lightness. Start to take in the colors around you. What do you see? Does your space have sparkling rays of light dabbling your skin? Does it radiate with color? Is it monochromatic? Is it brown? Breathe. Breathing in this lightness, you continue walking in your safe space. Become aware of the sounds around you. What do you hear? Is it the rustle of leaves crunching beneath your feet? The crinkle of dry grass? What kind of textures do you have beneath your feet? Do you hear blades of grass whistling in the wind? Touch those textures. Really tune in and deeply listen. Perhaps you hear the sound of distant water trickling down on a bed of rocks, or gushing downstream in abundance as the wind blows softly on your skin. You feel the warmth of that energy around you and you breathe. Notice the temperatures. Feel the air blow over your back and your neck, gently caressing your body. What does your world feel like? Is it hot like the desert sun your skin craves? Or is it cold and crisp? Perhaps it's temperate, mild, just right. Whatever the temperature is, really feel and relish in it. And as you relish in it and in this place of safety and comfort, perhaps you choose to wander down a path, feeling every sensation as you wander. You come to the quietest space in your imagined place, and you are calm and aware, giving yourself space. Sit down by a really lovely, comforting smell, the smell of something that brings you back home. And you realize you feel at peace. Everything in you is calm and at ease. Give yourself an inner smile, then waves of gratitude to your body and all of your senses for bringing you into the realm of reimagining. Trust. You are radiating with gratitude for this world. Breathe. Let's take in a collective breath in together. So let's breathe in through our nose and out through our mouth. Start to welcome back movement. I'd like to welcome you back to the space. Thank you for joining me on that journey. So as you're coming back to the space, feel free to write in the chat how that felt for you, if you'd like to share, or if you feel so inclined to unmute yourself and share how that felt, please do so. I'm definitely feeling calm. I feel really good. Thank you, JJ. I love your hair color. It's amazing. That was really soothing. Yes. Wonderful. Thank you, Anna. I'm glad to hear. It's definitely what I needed at the end of my day. Yeah, it is really cool to play with our imagination. I think that our imaginations are so powerful, and we do have the power to reimagine. Which leads me to what our art activity today is. We're going to be using tea and coffee to be playing around with abstract painting. So I'll drop a material list in the chat. Maybe we can take 5 minutes to go grab some material, and then I will guide you through how to use this material. And we're going to be creating pieces based on how we felt during that short visualization. So I have an extensive material list in the chat. Basically all you need is tea or coffee. If you have any spices accessible at home or vegetables that stain, like raspberries, a beetroot, anything like that, that works, anything to mark make, an old cloth or canvas or old t-shirt or a sock or anything like that is also great. And then I have options. And if you don't have any of those and you just want to watch along, that's absolutely fine as well. So I'll give people maybe 2 minutes. Or 5 minutes to go grab some tea. If you don't have fabric paper, it's great. Yep. To say thank you, illuminates it so far.
much.
That's awesome. So I was just asking if anyone has used coffee or tea to paint before. It absolutely is a thing. Luz, I love that you painted that with that in grade school. That's great. I love everything about painting with tea and coffee. It's such a forgiving medium to use. It honestly is incredibly forgiving. I started using it back in 2012 when I first came here. And initially it was because I couldn't find anything that reminded me of home. And we drink so much tea back home. But then I was also interested in a lot of things that were brought to our culture through colonialism that don't belong to us, and how you could sort of trace the route of colonialism through tea leaves, through the Brits, through India, through China. And so that was how I started using it. But it is honestly an incredible medium to use. So I won't hold you up. Let's get started, seeing as we don't have too much time. Can you guys hear me fine, by the way? Sorry. Okay, great. Oh my gosh, Katie, I'm loving the plants. Amazing. I have a fake plant background, but I'd love a real one. That's great. Awesome. So I've got a lot of things over here. I have a really lovely spread. I've got some coffee over here. I have some tea over here. And the first thing I'm going to do a really quick demo of is how to make your own inks. This is something that I find really cool. I learned the process through, I took an online botanical drawing class, but I'm always experimenting with inks and teas, and my studio feels like such a world of experimentation. So to make inks, usually I'll get ferrous sulfate. These are iron supplemental tablets that a lot of women and people will take, but you can get it at any pharmacy or grocery store. So all I'm doing is crushing the iron tablet. Unsuccessfully. There we go. I'm going to crush that iron tablet, and inside this little bowl over here, I'm just going to add a little bit of coffee. So this is coffee that's been sitting for, I want to say, like an hour. And so I'm also going to be adding some maple syrup and some tannins. So maple syrup and honey basically act like a binder. So whenever you want to make inks, you want something that will bind it or hold it together. If you don't have maple syrup, honey works. If you don't have that, gum arabic is also good, but I'm all for sustainable. So I go with syrups or natural material if I can. And I'm mixing the syrup as one part to the coffee. And then adding in the iron tablet, which I've just crushed. And then with this, I also have wine tannins.
So tannins are things you find in plants. You can find them in certain trees. You can find them in bark. You can find them in leaves. I get this version just because it's easier to work with. It's a powder. And it also reacts with the ferrous sulfate to sort of make it a little bit darker or blacker. So it's what sort of oxidizes the two. There are also a lot of natural materials will have tannins. So tea and coffee naturally do have tannins inside. So this is only because I want this ink black as it gets and thick because I love the color black. And it's really cool because as you see, this is brown. I'm just gonna paint over here. I have a piece of canvas. If you have an old t-shirt, you can use that too. Socks, whatever kind of fabric you have accessible to you at home. And you can see right now it's sort of a brownish ink, but because of the way the ferrous sulfate interacts with the tannins, you'll see it sort of turn black. You just need to give it a second to oxidize. It's really cool. I'm so geeked out by this stuff. And if you don't have the iron tablets or the tannins, you can also just paint with your tea or with your coffee. I'm gonna share my computer sound as well. I think it can be a really calming process. Painting with tea for me is very meditative. It's very much like life, like a push and pull backwards and forwards, always spilling and having these intentions and then reacting to what happens and changing that. Oh, that's awesome, using chlorophyll. Oh, that's great. Yeah, I like to be very experimental. If you have like leaves, if you have carrots, if you have turmeric works amazing. I really do love using turmeric. I haven't tried paprika. I know that's supposed to be good. Cinnamon's also supposed to be really good as a pigment. I've been using wine, like old wine. So whenever I don't finish off wine, it will go into my paintings. I have a lot of friends that drink coffee and tea, so I'm at their door on Monday Eve asking for the used coffee beans. Myself, I drink like 15 cups of tea a day, so when I'm done with the tea bags, I'll use them in paintings as well. So if you look at this ink that we just made, you'll see it's already starting to turn black in some areas, which I really love. And these are all like materials that are accessible at pharmacies or around the house. Over here, I have some tea. This is just a generic black tea, so I'm gonna use that as well because it's a different shade of brown. And I love just letting yourself play, experiment. If you're feeling abstract shapes today, paint abstract shapes and see what happens. And if you're feeling daring, I love spilling the tea on the canvas. Be either controlled or not so controlled. Just little drops and letting it sort of sink in. If you have different types of tea, that's amazing. I personally love using hibiscus tea. It's one of my favorite teas. Super beneficial. It's got a lot of benefits. But also it's really good for dyeing. It's got really intense hues and pigments. So even just the leaves, after they've been brewed, I will take and sort of drag across the canvas to try stain it. Mm-hmm. So I'm just using it to make marks. And if you have used black tea, those work really well as well. If you have green tea, that works as well. There's so many different kinds of tea that will work as different pigmentations for you. I'm really big on movement in whatever I paint. I'm just trying out things. If you feel like doing drips, that's something you can do. If you feel like dabbing your tea leaves on the canvas, that's something you can also do. So just pushing all the techniques and things you can do to your canvas or to your paper. I also have some turmeric here, which I really want to make paint with. So if I were to make an ink with this turmeric, I'd do the same thing that we just did, which would be adding a crushed iron tablet and tannins if I want to make it darker, a binder, which is my maple syrup, and water. But because I only want to make a paint, all I need for the turmeric is my binder and water. So I'm going to be mixing turmeric with the maple syrup and water. And the ratio of turmeric to the binder is 1 part to 1 part. So you want as much of your spice or whatever pigment as you're using to the amount of maple syrup or honey. Let me know if you guys have any questions as well, or how it's going. So for the turmeric paint, I literally have 1 part to 1 part maple syrup to the turmeric, and then a little bit of water to mix it up. And you can already see that this paint is sort of sticking together. And there are several different ways you can make paints from spices. I think this is just one that works for me and how simple it is and that it holds together, which is great. And then I'm going to go ahead and just start painting with that. And you can see that lovely yellow hue that happens when mixed in with the tea. I like to really get lost in just like painting with these mediums and figuring out like what's around your house that you can paint with. There are so many things. I think as soon as you start thinking about alternative medium to acrylics and oils, then you have a whole world. Something I've been dying to try out is soil. I don't know why I've not painted with the earth. I've done it with clay before, but I haven't done it with soil, and I'd love to try that. And so while I'm using the tea as well, I love learning about the plant itself. Hibiscus, for example, I never knew there are hundreds of different hibiscus flowers, but only one of them is the one that we use for hibiscus tea, which is amazing. And then something I also love doing is adding texture to whatever I'm painting. So I will go ahead and use, oh, hibiscus water is amazing, Anna. It is so healthy. Yeah, and really refreshing in the summer with just a little bit of mint iced is amazing. So to add texture, I'll add a little bit of my maple syrup as my binder, or think of it as my glue. And then I'll go ahead and just add some coffee grounds. So some used coffee grounds to the painting to give it some texture. And as this dries, it will stick down, which is great. So I like to think of painting very much like cooking up different experiments and seeing what I can come up with. And then just experimenting. So I also have flour. This is just plain flour, which I'm going to be mixing with salt and water. It's one part salt to one part flour. And I'm going to be making a little bit of a thicker white paint or pigment. So it's one part salt to one part flour and water. This is one of the easiest methods to make paint. If you have food coloring, for example, you can also use white flour to one part salt and add whatever food coloring you want to make your own paint. Just thinking about the textures and things you can add to your painting. And when I was doing the guided visualization, my world was a place by a large body of water, because I am so calm by water. And I think that this medium is very watery. It's very fluid. So I also like thinking about painting with teas and coffees as a dye. And so the way I painted it today is more like a painting, but if you wanted this to sit in the fabric and to sit inside your fabric, all you do is that you would let it sit in a cup or two cups of water to one cup of white vinegar, and that would keep the color inside the fabric itself. So I've been playing around with different dyes and natural dyes and seeing what I can come up with. I've been working on dyeing baby clothes. And so these are just little cute little minis with tea and letting them soak in the tea. And then after that, to keep the color in, I've just soaked them in vinegar and water. So that's one part vinegar to two parts water for 1 hour, and then going ahead and rinsing. I've also been playing around with avocado skins, so boiling fabric in avocado skins. I don't know if you can see that. It's got a really lovely sort of pink pale color. And that's literally just two avocado skins that I've boiled with fabric for 2 hours. So there's several things you can do with the medium once you start letting yourself play with it and thinking about the medium as either a dye or as a medium to stain or as a medium to paint with. This is getting to a place where I like it. I think I might leave it there and I might come back and add some white paint later on when it dries. Sometimes I like to play as well with different variations of certain type of tea. So like black tea, making one brew that is like with one tea bag, the next one with two tea bags, three tea bags, and just playing around with color, letting it sit on the fabric for a day, 2 days, and seeing what happens, staining and coming back. We see that we have 10 more minutes left. I wonder if anyone is comfortable to share what they have so far or how it's going.
I'll go for it. Do you want me to like hold up what I made?
Yeah, if you can, feel free to.
Okay, can y'all see?
Oh, that's beautiful. Oh, I love that. Wow. Oh, that's gorgeous. Can you tell us a little bit about what you made, JJ?
So this was really just about like mindfulness and like experimentation and like play and just kind of like movement throughout the page. I like to draw these little like generational trauma squiggles. So I'll probably go in with like black marker, like a paint pen, and like draw on top and stuff.
I love that. Thank you so much for sharing. That's beautiful. And what kind of teas are you using?
So I use coffee.
Okay.
I use smoked paprika. I use turmeric, and then I use some gold mica powder.
Ooh.
I'm a resin artist, so I have a bunch of like mica powders on deck. So I thought I'd throw that in there. I'd love to experiment with glitter.
I love that. Yeah, I saw your Instagram before we joined. I love everything you're doing. It's amazing. Oh my God,
thank you.
That's great. Thank you for sharing.
Thank you.
Katie, would you like to share?
Sure. It's a little wet because it's paper, but I had turmeric and then cinnamon and coffee. And I didn't have any time to steep anything, so it's pretty chunky. Oh, and then I used some leaves.
Oh.
I know all of these crumbs are going to fall on the ground right
now. Oh, that's lovely. I love these yellows. Ooh, warm. That's beautiful. Oh, so cool. What did you use for like the in-between parts, like in the circles and the white circles?
I just filled in the space on the outside with gold or the gold.
Okay, got it. Mm-hmm. Oh, those are lovely.
Thank you.
Oh, I love this.
A little chunky tree. Oh, and yeah. I used a guava leaf to make the marks, and then I tried to make a tea out of it, but that didn't really work. But
oh.
Now
oh, that's awesome. There's so many things I want to try. I really want to try potato teas, like that sort of thing, boiled avocado seeds. Like there's so much. That's awesome. Thank you for sharing. Did anyone else want to share how that felt or what they created or what you want to create?
I can share. So I made a mask.
So oh, I love that.
I used pomegranate to like make it splatter, but then I was like, oh my God, people are gonna think it's like blood. I guess I'm always insecure when I make like abstract art, I guess, because I'm like, are people gonna get it? But I really like it. And I use wine and vanilla extract.
Ooh.
And then chlorophyll.
Oh, that's beautiful. How do you get the chlorophyll?
The chlorophyll is like it's like liquid. Yeah. Oh, wow. It's derived from elderberry, and it's really like, it's kind of sweet. It's really good.
Oh, that's so cool. That's beautiful. I love that you made a mask. It's very fitting.
And then so I just like exploded the pomegranates onto the, like that was fun part too. Like I was just like watching it explode. But I don't know, does this stay? Will it stay or do you have to
do it? So basically to make it stay, you want to sit it in like 2 cups of water to one cup of white vinegar, and you want to steep that fabric in there for 1 hour. And then after that 1 hour, you can rinse it out with cold water, and then just for care, taking care of it afterwards, you want to wash it in cold water, hand wash it, dry it up in shady places. That would be a great project. You should make masks for everyone. That's lovely. I love that. Thank you guys so much for sharing. I know we only have 5 more minutes, so I wanted to share one more slide with you all. And this is from a book I'm reading right now. It is called Undrowned. It's by Alexis Pauline Gums, Black Feminist Lessons from Marine Mammals. It is amazing. I'm in love with sea creatures and all of that. But she talks in this chapter about getting deep with each other. And it's in the context of these whales that can dive up to 1 mile below the sea level, which is amazing. So she says, step one is to breathe. Sperm whales can replace 90% of the air in their lungs with one breath. They can blow their breath 17 feet high.
However deep you're breathing, breathe more and breathe deeper. Step two, take responsibility for your forehead. She says, we whales, for example, have a head full of wax. We can solidify like a weight to go deeper. We can melt it to become lighter than water and float. What is going on in your head? Be intentional with it. Step three, hush. We stretch out our bodies 60 feet long at the surface and then arc our backs facing down. Our tails come with us barely creating a ripple. We are saving our energy for depth. This is not the time to splash. Step four, be flexible. Deep in the ocean, there is pressure, a lot of pressure. It will press on your chest and your lungs will collapse. You call it heartbreak, it is not. It is how what made you embraces you, reshapes you, welcomes you back, let it happen. Step five, be specific in your actions. When your lungs collapse, you will need the oxygen in your blood. It is deep in your muscles. It was put there by practice. Let your practice facilitate depth. It will be there when you need it. Step six, she says, is to listen. We listen underneath our throats, not with our ears. We listen across the planet. We can hear each other click from opposite sides of the globe. Though we may seem alone, we never are. And step seven, which I adore, is come back. You will know when it has been enough time in the deep. It can vary. Attune to your need, account for your nourishment, direct your thoughts, melt them down, make them light, and then return. So I just wanted to share that with you because I think it's really impactful in getting deep with each other, deep with yourself, deep with our communities, and doing the things that will help us reimagine worlds where we want to be. We've got three more minutes. Did anyone have any thoughts they wanted to share, or perhaps a one-word checkout of how they're feeling right now, how you're feeling right now?
I'm feeling really inspired, so thank you.
I'm loving these, grounded, coming back. Yeah, Jennifer. There's a type of dolphin she talks about, which I want to say it's the tiger dolphin, I'm not too sure, which always comes to the surface and the shoreline, knowing that it will return back. So it plays with what's on the surface, but it will return back to where it came from, which is grounded. Hima, it is a really good smelling painting, that's for sure. Anna says they feel content. I love that. I'm loving these feelings of creativity. I really encourage you to explore what's in your house. There's so much just around us. Smelling all the herbs and plants from earth is so comforting. Yes. Yeah, I really do enjoy that. Just working with the earth. I wanted to share two more things. I've been offering tea workshops, thinking about sustainability. I'll drop a link in the chat. If you guys would like to stay in touch, please do sign up at my email link on the bottom. Thank you so much for having me, Luce, and for this whole conference. I'm really excited to check out some other talks and workshops.
Honestly, thank you. This is awesome. This was fun.
Yeah, I want to do it again, and I want like 2 hours. We need more time.
Okay. All right, everyone. Well, you have a long break right now, and then there's an open mic at 7 if anyone's interested in doing some poetry supporting some poetry readings. We got a full lineup. A lot of people signed up, so that should be fun. But go get some food.
Will do.
Enjoy the rest of your night, everybody.
You too. Thank you.
Thank you so much.